This video is created by Jagrat Creation. It is on departmental accounts. I wish to solve one sum here before you on departmental accounts. Observe the sum on the screen. Farways Limited is a retail organization with several departments. Goods supplied to its department are debited at a memorandum departmental stock account at cost plus fixed percentage of markup to give the normal sales price. So stock account is maintained at the sales value. Sales value is made of cost plus markup. The markup is credited to the memorandum departmental markup account, and a reduction in the sales price markdown will require to be adjusted in the stock account and the markup account. The markup of department A for the last 3 years was 40%. So when the goods were sent, the markup was 40%. Markup has been 40%. Figures relevant to the department A for the year ended on 30th June 2017 were as follows. Opening stock purchase is sales. It is further ascertained that goods purchased in a period were marked down of 1400 from a cost of 16,000. Marked down stock costing 4,000 remain unsold on 30th June 2017. So goods provided had a markdown. So goods purchased. So this purchase is a markdown, and out of this markdown items, in spite of the markdown, they could not be sold and they are carried forward in the stock at the end of the accounting period. Stock shortage for the year ended was cost to be 1200, which is to be written off. Stock on 1st of July 2016, including goods costing 8,200, has been sold during the year and had been marked down in a sales price of 740. The remaining stock has been sold during the year. So stock on 1st of July to including goods costing 8,200 has been sold during the year, had been marked down in a sales price 740. The remaining stock had been sold during the year. The departmental closing stock is to be valued at the cost subject to adjustment of markup and markdown. You are required to prepare departmental trading account for a department for the year ended on 31st of for the year ended on June 2017 in the head office books, and memorandum stock account and markup account for the year. So these are the two accounts that we are required to prepare. We shall find out the profit by preparing these last two accounts, and we shall also find out the gross profit by preparing the trading account. The profit that we find by preparing trading account and the profit that we may get in this markup account should be same. Let us start. So this is the memorandum stock account at sales value. The profit element in this increase in stock will be credited here. The profit element in the decline of stock other than sales will be debited. Similarly, opening stock is at a loaded price, so opening stock reserve is there. Closing stock will be at a loaded price, there will be a closing stock reserve at the end of the accounting period. So stock at cost 80,000, that is recorded in the normal trading account. But in this stock account is prepared not at cost but at sales price. So here the profit will be added. Markup is 40%. 100 is to 40. How much for 32,000 markup? So 32,000 is the markup that I write in the inner column because there exists a markdown. Now purchase 180,000. In trading account is recorded cost. These are two working notes. This is the part of books of accounts. So here also 180,000 in this working note is recorded. There is a markup of 40%. 72,000 is added here. 72,000 will be credited over here. Sales will be recorded in the sales value in trading account, and the same sales will be recorded in the stock account at the normal sales value. So like 20,000. Goods purchased in a period where markdown of 1400 from the cost of 16,000. Markdown stock costing 4,000 remain unsold on 30th June 2017. So this goods purchased for a period markdown by 1400, cost is 16,000. So when the cost is 16,000, markdown is how much? 1400. And this item is a part of this 180,000 that I'm explaining to you. So there was a markdown of 1400. So markdown entry is what? Markup account debit to stock account credit, markdown. Now shortage of stock that is recorded to the credit side of trading account, and same shortage is recorded in the stock account, but this is at cost. 100 is to 40, 480 is the markdown. So this is the sales value, and when you record the sales value, the profit element needs to be reversed. So you have to write on the debit side of memorandum markup account in this fashion. As I have uploaded nearly 3 sums of this type on YouTube, and if you have observed them on YouTube, in this sum, I just solve the sum without going much into the details of the theory. So this is how loss is identified. Now closing stock. On 1st of July 2006, including goods costing 8,200 has been sold during the year, had a markdown in the sales price of 740, the remaining stock has been sold during the year. So this is the about opening stock. Opening stock on 1st of July 2016. Stock on 1st of July 2016 including 8,200 has been sold during the year, had been marked down of 740. So there is a normal markup of 32,000. There was a markdown of 720. So in this opening stock reserve also 720 will be deducted. Now in the previous sum, this point was given first. While in this sum, this point is given third. That's the only difference. So markup, normal markup, markdown. So this is a value which is not normal markup. Normal markup minus planned markdown. Now, all this opening stock is sold. So this 320,000, wherein all this opening stock markdown is sold, and the remaining sales is out of other purchases, out of current purchases. This is a sale. This is just an explanation. Otherwise, you can write straight with sale 320,000 without any trouble. Now, departmental stock is to be valued at cost, subject to adjustment of markup. So 16,000 is to 1400 markdown. How much for 4,000? So the stock that you find in the stock account is not at normal markup, but it holds the markdown stock as its segment. So if you find out the closing stock in this memorandum stock account, the stock will not be found at the usual markup of 40%, because markdown stock existed in the closing stock. So how much was the markdown existed in the closing stock? 350. So 350 was a part of this 1400. So no story, just for the explanation purpose, I go for a markup of 350, so I will credit 350 here. So after recording this 350, I will find out the stock. Then I will get the stock at the usual markup. So usual markup stock is 40,050. So sales value is 140. If there is a usual markup, the sales value is 140. So 140 is to 40 load. How much for 40,005? So this is the stock reserve. Now this is for explanation. I have gone for a markup. There was a markdown of 1400, 350 is a part thereof. To explain this note, I have just notionally recorded 350 markup to reverse this markdown. This markdown of 1400, 1/4 thereof is being reversed, and the stock is found out as usual. And this is how the, now if you transfer this 350 on the opposite side, you will get the stock at usual markup minus markdown, just like usual markup minus markdown. Here the value of 40,530 is at usual markup minus markdown, markdown 350. So transfer this 350 on the opposite side. So now the stock is just like this level. Usual markup plus markdown, usual markup plus markdown. And this 350 is transferred to this side. So there is, it is not a usual markup profit. This is a usual markup minus markdown profit. So this is one way to explain. Now the another way. Now find out OR. the other way to explain the same thing. Total of debit side minus credit side, 40,180. 350 is the markdown is added back to find the stock at the usual markup. So stock at regular markup you will receive. Regular load therein is how much? 40 upon 140 as I explained to you. Now this is the usual regular stock minus 350. So this is the stock reserve. Let me write down stock reserve here. Now I will get the profit. So here we will get the profit. Transfer to profit and loss account. 19,150 is the gross profit. Now let me write down the stock at cost in my trading account. 40,180 minus 11,230. That is the cost of stock. That I write on the credit side of trading account. Now I would like to find out the profit through trading account. It will be 90,150. So profit that you find out by preparing trading account and the profit that you get in markup account will be same. Look at it. This is how this sum gets solved. So I have tried to explain to this sum. I feel that you have followed all these things. Thanks to all.